Let me show you a great chat question and answer application example. I'll be using OPA, the Open Platform for Enterprise AI. This example can run on various clouds, various devices, CPUs and GPUs and AI accelerators like Gaudi. It is robust, it is scalable, and very easy to operate. OPA simplifies the development, the production, and adoption of GenAI applications for enterprise by providing containerized, multi-platform, multi-vendor, and device microservices. You can use each microservice by itself, I'll show you in a minute, or use many microservices controlled by a mega service to operate the full application. Let me show you how it looks like. Best place to start is opa.dev. You can find here lots of testimonials, a list of partners and contributors, and more. Go to technical documentation. Again, lots of information. And getting started, how to operate each of the microservices and GenAI examples. Chat Q&A is a very popular usage, and here you can find all the explanations, how does it work, and how does microservices are connected and function, and how to actually run it in a single node or on a Kubernetes cluster. This sample is basically using an LLM or a TGI, Text Generation Interface microservice, basically standard Hugging Face service. So you could just send it a prompt and get a response. Pretty simple, we'll see how it works in a minute. But if you'd like to use newer or more relevant private data, you'd like to use RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation. So you need to load a document holding the new data and use a data preparation microservice to convert it from whatever format it is into plain text. Then we need to take each chunk of the text and generate an embedding vector using the embedding microservice. Then we need to place this embedding vector in a vector store. The retrieval microservice can get an embedding vector as an input and perform similarity checks against the other vectors in the vector store. This information is used by the re-ranking microservice to decide which of the text chunks, which of the vectors, is more relevant to augment our prompt and to be fed into the TGI microservice. The service that is in charge of operating all these microservices is called a mega service. Let's see it in action. Let's get a machine from the Intel Tiber AI Cloud. I'll take a CPU, Xeon machine, strong enough but cheap enough. Provisioning and machine is ready. This is my machine. How to connect? I'm in. LS CPU. Yes, I have a strong Xeon machine. Search for OPA GitHub. I'll leave you the link below. You got here components, documents, and more. I'll go for the AI examples. First thing, we'll clone the repository, and you can see here quite a few examples. I'll try the chat Q&A. Docker Compose. You can run this example on AMD, on NVIDIA, but I'll run it on Intel hardware. Not on Gaudi, on a CPU, not on an AI PC, on a Xeon, and I'll just follow the instructions. Set up few environment variables, initialize, and three, Docker Compose. That is all. I'll set up the host IP. You have to make sure you get permissions to the models. The default one is Llama 8 billion, and I got the access. Go to settings and copy the token. Initialize the environment and Docker Compose app will bring you everything you need. It might take a while. It's a lot of data to download. Docker PS-A. Yes, I have few services up and running. This is a one-click example, but it will run several separate microservices. And now I can go and use each one of them separately. For example, this is the embedding microservice. I can provide a prompt, for example, what is deep learning? And the service is providing me with ready embedding for that prompt Here it is. I can check the re-ranking microservice. My prompt is, what is deep learning? And I like to rank which text is closer or better to answer. So the first text that starts with deep learning is not is almost zero match. And the second text that starts with deep learning is almost one. Or I can try the full example using the mega service, hand it a meaningful question like what is the height of the Eiffel Tower, and it uses all the microservices to operate the full pipeline and generate the answer for me. Yes, excellent, magnifique. Now, each of the microservices is highly flexible and configurable. For example, in the setenv script, you can choose a different embedding, a different ranker, a different LLM, and so on. Just make sure you have the permissions to use them. Pretty cool. Multi-microservices managed by one mega service to perform a RAG chatbot. There are many other examples. Check them out. Link below. Subscribe. Thank you.